The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "No one come to me unless he is drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, they will all be taught by God, and to hear the teaching of the Father and learn from it is to come to me. Not that anybody has seen the Father except the one who comes from God. He has seen the Father. I tell you most solemnly, everybody who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the desert and they are dead. But this is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that a man may eat it and not die. I am the living bread which has come down from heaven. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, how can we come to know Christ? Today's the Gospel says, God the Father has to draw us to Christ. God the Father always draws us to Christ. And we should be very vigilant, and we should be very careful in every situation, every moment of our life, because every moment God speaks to us and draws us to Christ. Today is the first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. We find an Ethiopian official, treasurer of the Queen of the Ethiopia, was making a journey to Jerusalem, a pilgrimage, and he was going through the scripture, Prophet Isaiah, and he was not able to understand what it is written, to whom it is written. And he was so anxious, and that scripture which he was reading really was an moment, an opportunity God reveals. That is the moment God inspired Philip, go to this Ethiopian. And he entered into his chariot and sat with him and opened the scripture and explained to him what exactly it is written. He only just explained, but it touched him, Ethiopian. On the way, he asked Philip, "Philip, there is a water here. Can you give me the baptism?" Philip never asked him to take the baptism. It is the God who inspired through Philip. That's why I say that there are moments God draws closer to Christ. It is not only the scripture. Sometimes it is maybe the Holy Mass. It may be another occasion, another opportunity. God always draws to Christ. At times we are very blind, we are deaf, we are not able to recognize and realize the hand of God. And there should be people like Philip to explain it. Sometimes parents has the responsibility to play the role of a Philip, sometimes a teacher, sometimes someone else. So try to be a Philip and try to recognize and realize that God is calling me to explain it, not only with the words, with our life. So we need people like Philip. We also need people like Ethiopian. Open every opportunity, open the mind, open the ears, eyes to know the hand of God. And my brothers and sisters, in today's gospel, Jesus says, "I am the bread of life." It's not easy to believe that Jesus is in the Holy Eucharist, little bread. That's why someone has to draw us. the deeper faith is needed. There are people who left Christ when they said that Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Not only Jesus, people were leaving, he said, my flesh, if you don't eat, you will not have the life. He went even deeper. My brothers and sisters, we need a deep faith like Ethiopian. We need people like Philip to explain to us. So may the Lord give us the inspiration and guidance each and every moment of our life so that we may always experience the presence of Christ. And Ethiopian, how he left? He left joyfully. The moment he experienced Christ, there was a great joy in his life. The same way, if you want to be happy and joyful, we have to experience Christ truly and really. For that, we need a deep faith. May God bless each and every one of us so that we may be drawn to Christ and we may be guided by Christ, we may be empowered by Christ, and we too may have the grace to be another Philip to speak and explain about the scripture and any events, and we may bring Christ to everyone's life. Amen.